Welcome back. A groundbreaking ceremony was held last week on a Kewaunee County dairy farm for a first-of-its-kind facility that will be converting methane to a natural gas. Mike Austin shares that story in today's Ag Report.
Which is gas that comes from cows, but it strictly meets the same methane and specifications of regular natural gas. And we're taking that gas and we're going to use that as vehicle fuel in compressed natural gas vehicles.
In explaining the process, which is running on a farm in Indiana, Kevin Dobson of DTE says its main focus is converting a waste product into a renewable asset.
What we're going to be doing is taking that gas, and instead of burning it in a flare, we're going to be taking it and purifying it into renewable natural gas. So the end result is methane, but then the tail gas, the things that we can't use, we're going to combust in what's called a thermal oxidizer, and that is so much more environmentally beneficial. That's going to take the emissions, the CO2 emissions, and reduce it by over 97%.
Now, Pagel sees the investment as a way for his farm to reduce its environmental footprint.
It'll help the environment around the nation by taking extra trucks off the road or being able to use the natural gas instead of having to use diesel fuel all the time. The other thing is it'll reduce our carbon footprint. By burning less gas, not allowing it to go into the atmosphere, we're burning less gas off and we'll be having a cleaner environment for everybody.
Now, this compressed natural gas will be used mostly for trucks and bus fleets, but its impact will be substantial.
The greenhouse gas savings is equivalent to removing over 9,200 vehicles from the road each year, or roughly 5 million gallons of gasoline consumed.
Now, Pagel's Ponderosa will be joined by three other northeastern Wisconsin farms in this process. And even though it's quite a financial commitment, Pagel says the end result goes well beyond just economics.
It's definitely not a cheap operation, but at the end of the day, when we weigh things out, we look at the social, environmental, and economic aspect of it. And at the end of the day, it's a win-win for everybody.
Reporting from Kewaunee County, Mike Austin, Local 5 News.